on to rugby union, and tomorrow's the penultimate round of the Kings of the Sevens tournament in the Borders. We'll be hearing from a Scottish rugby legend shortly. But first, Stuart Cameron takes a look at the current state of affairs in the series.
Melrose have taken the last four events and have already broken the record total with 68 points. But only 4 points separate second place Gala, Hoyk and Watsonians in third, and Edinburgh Accies in fifth, with Selkirk still in contention for a top four spot below them. The quality of rugby at these abbreviated events is superb. No wonder the fans flock to enjoy around 5 hours of rugby. And last weekend at Kelso and Earlston, well over 200 tries were scored. And while they were chased all the way by Hoyk and Gala last weekend, Melrose were confirmed as Kings of the Sevens champions. And I asked Melrose star Bruce Dick how good he thinks the squad is.
It's good, it's up there, definitely. I was fortunate to be part of the Kings of the Sevens winning side a few years ago when we had the likes of James King, Scott White. You know, that side was good, but we're not going to say we're the best side, because you know some great legends that have played at Melrose, and we'll take the plaudits if they come, but we can't get ahead of ourselves.
We've enjoyed some fantastic rugby in the Kings of the Sevens over the past few weeks, but now we're up to round nine. We come here to Philiphaugh in Selkirk.
And a look at the draw shows us that on form we should see Selkirk, Melrose, Jed Forrest and Gala going through, but Hoyk and Kelso could well join them in the quarter-finals if they can get past good Edinburgh opposition. And as Selkirk president and former Scottish international John Rutherford told me, the competition is wide open.
If you took Melrose out, you could look at maybe six or seven clubs that they could all win that tournament. And like I said right at the beginning, it's up to us all to get up to Melrose's level and be much more competitive.
Selkirk themselves will be looking to repeat their win at their own tournament, and with the likes of Darren Clapperton and Mikey Davis on the side here scoring last Sunday, they're certainly capable of winning again. Stuart Cameron, ITV News.